Welcome to International Securities Exchange's podcast series. Facilitated by renowned educators, ISE podcasts are intended to teach beginning as well as seasoned investors the ins and outs of trading. To find an updated list of podcasts, please visit www.ise.com/podcasts. Please be sure to listen to our important message following this episode regarding the risks of investing in exchange-traded options.
So here's an example. So option traders, they would call this a straddle. You could also construct it as a strangle. And I'm going to draw another line here. So let's get rid of my lower support line. I'm drawing a line right through where prices are right now. Let's round things up to 88. Let's say that prices were at basically 88 on the yen. By the way, the index option for this, or the option for this, currency option for this, the symbol is YUK. So let's say that we bought to open at the strike price of 88, we'll give this a lot of time to expire, or a fair amount of time before expiration. So let's say October's expiration. So I'm just kind of making a couple of notes here. What's that going to cost us? Well, let's say it costs us about 380. So $380, because we're buying to open both a call and a put at the 88 strike price. So the put will become worth a lot more money if the market drops, and the call will become worth a lot more money if the market rises a lot. So one of these sides is probably going to be a loser. Well, is definitely going to be a loser, and one of these sides is probably going to be a winner. And if the market moves enough, then the winner will actually outpace the loser. And in fact, we have unlimited upside potential. If the market moved really surprised and moved a lot, so traders were getting ready for big announcements, things like this. Sometimes they'll set up a straddle or a strangle like this where they're taking both a bearish and a bullish position with calls and puts at the same time. So at 380, so it costs us 380. So if we were to assume that we held this position all the way through to expiration, so we held this position all the way until the third Friday in October before we wanted to get rid of it. Where would we need prices to be? So I marked, here's the third Friday in October. If we were to not exit the position, so we just leave it alone. And so I just got a question here from Ron. What's the cost of the straddle? The cost of the straddle, as I priced it this afternoon, looked to be about $380. So that'd be $380 per contract. But if you're a Forex trader, let me tell you what that means. Okay? So you would actually add the cost of this position to your strike price that you're selling, so 88. So that would put us at 92.80 at about right here, and we would also subtract that amount from the strike price, which would put us down about 84.20, which is right about here. So this creates two little barriers. That as long as the market, and remember, we're kind of estimating this based on, what if the market, breaks out a lot, and we held it all the way through till expiration. If it's beyond one of these two barriers by this point here, then we start to accumulate profits. And the closer it is to either of these two barriers, the smaller, so let's say it doesn't get to either of these two barriers, but, gets pretty close to one of them. Well, we will have some losses, but we won't have lost everything that we'd invested, because let's say the market went up a lot but didn't quite get beyond this upper barrier. So we got to maybe 91.50 or something like that. The trade has lost value. The put's certainly worth a lot less, but that call has accumulated some value, and that value offsets some of those losses. So we haven't lost everything. In fact, the only way we would lose the entire amount is if the market expired at exactly 88, because then both options would expire worthless. So traders will use this as a way to take advantage of an opportunity where they're expecting a big move in the market, but they don't know which direction. So Forex traders are a little bit trapped in this situation, because if they bought and shorted the market at the same time, either their dealer would net out the position to nothing, or they would or they'd have a position that was a perfect offset, that as far as the market went up, they'd be losing on the short side, and as far as the market went down, they'd be losing on the long side. So it offsets those two things. So And so, Steve, I know you have a question about the YUK October 88 straddle at 211 and 107 for the put and the call. What I would suggest is, you know, the market's closed right now, and so the spreads get a little wide, and the Forex market, it continues to move 24 hours a day, basically 5 days a week, and the options. The index stops moving at the close of market. So what I would suggest is, you know, use my numbers as an example and then go back tomorrow morning and quote it at, you know, what live prices are like. So you get a feel for, you know, okay, what would this straddle actually cost? And, you know, what's the spread, et cetera? So you get a better feel for what the prices actually are. Because during the close of market, just depending on your trading platform and what time it is and all this kind of stuff, it may actually throw those prices off. So use my prices as an example, and then go in tomorrow morning and check it out. You know, throw a little paper trade on and just watch it in your notebook for a few weeks and see how it plays out. The Forex is really well known for this unexpected volatility, which puts neutral trades like this in, it makes them very interesting. So,
hey, John, question, yeah. Would you mind just showing how you got that straddle by adding the call and put? I think you did, but there was a question about that.
You bet. So, Steve, I'm not absolutely sure what you're asking, but let me break it out. Let me break it out.
Yeah, Kay said, can you do the straddle again? I think she just wants to know, okay, you know, call for $1.90, put for $1, you know, roughly. That's what you were saying.
Okay. So, here's I'm going to give you really rough numbers here. So let's say the 88 strike price call, that's going to cost me, you know, at this point, they were a little bit cheaper than the puts, as I remember, and so we were in about almost $2 even. No, that's not right. I'm sorry. About $1.70. So per share, and I'm kind of pulling this a little bit from memory because I pulled the total price. But when you go look at this yourself, you'll see what I'm talking about. So and then the 88 strike price.
Hey, John. It closed off at 390, so you were really close. I'm looking at the quotes as of right now.
390, really,
you think? Yeah, it closed off at 390, so you might be able to, you know, tomorrow morning possibly fill at 380 if it's off at 390.
Okay. So it sounds like I'm not too far off. So here's approximately the prices that I was looking at before the market closed. So the 88 strike call cost $1.70. And the 88 strike put cost $2.10. Now, what happens is that as the market rises, so if the market goes up, the call is going to start gaining in value and the put's going to start falling in value. If the market were to drop, the put is going to start rising in value and the call is going to start falling in value. Now, at some point, if the market moves enough, then the call, so if it moves enough to the upside, the call is going to start outpacing the losses on the put, and the trade on the aggregate, when you put them together, is actually going to become more valuable than what it was originally. So it's one of these ways to step into the market with a more neutral attitude, where we're not trying to forecast what direction the market may go, but rather we're trying to forecast a little bit about coming volatility. So when we buy a straddle, a long straddle like this, what we're essentially buying is we're buying into rising volatility. We think that the market is going to increase in volatility and it's going to create a big move. We just don't know which direction.
Thank you for listening to our podcast. To find more podcasts on options, stocks, alternative markets, and market data, please visit www.ise.com/podcasts.